I have always been quite cynical, but I've also always loved a good science experiment. I'm a bit of a nerd at heart. And when I have discovered this electroculture stuff, I have been really fascinated by it and quite cynical about some of the woo-woo craziness that seems to also go along with some of the instructions. So I took it upon myself to try a bunch of experiments to see what actually works and what's really not working. You may have seen some of my previous videos on using magnets to start seeds, which I found super fascinating. You can see it up here. And also an experiment, just a preliminary one, testing out a few different aerials just on some mustard cover crop that I had sown outside. It had already sprouted and I added these aerials, and then I have followed along with some videos on the progress with the growth of those. I found the result really fascinating, that the best one seemed to be a stick stuck in the ground, not very tall, with some copper wrapped around it. And to me that seemed like the most silliest idea, but the results did speak for themselves. However, I'm never one to try something once and assume that is the end result. So I decided to set up a whole nother experiment in the tunnel house, because I don't know if you can hear right now, it's raining. It's basically winter here now. And so my germination outside's not doing so great. I do have some other experiments set up and underway, but the seeds are taking forever to germinate. So I thought I'd do this in the tunnel house. What I did was took 6 pots, and I have set up some different copper aerials in those pots and left them for a few weeks to see what effect they have had. So in there, of course, they all had the exact same amount of potting mix. I used the exact same amount of seeds. They are all just a simple yellow mustard seed used usually for cover cropping. But the reason I picked those was that they grow nice and fast and they don't mind the fact that it's a little bit cold right now. So obviously one of those 6 pots was a control. So I added no aerials to those, just some seeds, some dirt and some water. All 6 pots have had the exact same amount of water, the same amount of light. They've been in the same conditions. The results that you can see are, the only thing I can put it down to is these aerials. One of them I have put a Lakhovsky coil, which is literally just a circle with a little opening, so they end up like this, and so you put the opening pointing out to the south. One of them I did the exact same thing, but had the opening pointing to the north, which is officially the correct way of doing it. And I did use a compass to find out north and south to make sure I was getting it bang on magnetic north and magnetic south. The third one, I did one of those coils where you twist the 2 bits of wire together and make a closed loop. I can't remember the name of it, but I'll put it up here for you. So it doesn't have to point in any particular direction. So I put that on the soil as well. And then numbers 5 and 6 were the old bamboo stake with some copper wrapped around it. One was looking down from the top, clockwise down, and the other was anti-clockwise. Now officially we are in the southern hemisphere, so we are supposedly meant to have better results with this wound anti-clockwise. But as you will see with the results, this was not my experience. I actually found the results of these really quite fascinating, and here are the results.
So this was the one with the Lakhovsky coil with the opening, and it was pointing south, which for us is sort of that sort of direction. And this is the resulting growth, and clearly compared to some of these, it's significantly less well grown. So we'll take a wee cutting of those and we'll compare them soon. So they're obviously quite little and not particularly well grown. So what we might do is move those over there and just keep a little collection here to be able to compare them. This one was the old copper around the stick, and it is wound, wait for it, anti-clockwise from the top down, which officially being in the southern hemisphere, I've been told that's the way to do it. But these plants are nowhere near as lush as these ones, which are the ones wound clockwise from the top down. Look at that difference. And we'll take a sample of these, and again you can see the leaves are not all that big. Some of them seem quite little. They've kind of just don't seem to have thrived very well. All right, next we have these ones seem to have grown pretty well. They've sort of bushing out the top of the pot there, and these leaves are obviously quite large in comparison with those other two. Have a look and see what this one is. It is, one moment please, the Lakhovsky coil, whatever it's called, where this opening was pointing magnetic north. So this is comparing, these are the Lakhovsky coil with the opening facing north. This is the exact same coil but with the opening facing south. I think this one is growing the absolute best out of all of them. There's clearly a lot of weight to those leaves. They're busting out everywhere. And this is the copper wrapped around the stick, going clockwise from the top down. Again, this is anti-clockwise from the top down. This is clockwise from the top down. I'll just remove a few of these plants so it's a bit more of a comparable bunch. I keep forgetting the name of this one. This one seems to have grown sort of averagely midly. It's not super awesome, but it also isn't super bad. And this is where you get, sorry little plants, two copper wires, and you twist them together to make a circle and then just sit it on the ground. And it's certainly grown more than the two that have done badly, but it hasn't done super well compared to some of them. So we'll put that in that wee pile there. And this one here is the control. I did nothing with this. You can see there's a bit of pest damage on here, which actually I haven't found on any of the other ones, except this one that looked particularly rough. There's definitely some pest pressure on there. That was the Lakhovsky coil facing south, facing the wrong way. Yeah, there's definitely some pest pressure on this one. It's actually had quite a lot. Other than that, it seems to have grown a fair amount of leaf. So it'll be interesting to compare them all together. So that's the control. I did nothing extra to that one. So I'm just going to put these in order of goodness to badness. These two are fairly on par, but this one has, the control has got pest pressure. This one certainly grew slightly, pretty similar, but without the pest pressure. So I think we will slip the control in there. We're going to get a little up close and personal looking at them. The worst by far growing all of them was the Lakhovsky coil with the opening facing the wrong way, so facing south. The next worst was a stick with the copper wound anti-clockwise. Now this one was the control, so these two definitely did worse than the control. The one thing the control has that some of the next one doesn't have is some pest pressure. So this one has been eaten by a few things. This is the coil. A similar amount of growth as the control, but not the same pest pressure. The leaves on the coil one are actually darker green. In second to top place was the Lakhovsky coil facing north. These plants are nice and green, they're quite big, very healthy, heaps of growth. And then the very best out of all of them, which I find very surprising, is this bamboo stick with the copper twisted clockwise. Even though I'm in the southern hemisphere, these definitely produce the most leaves, the heaviest weight, they're very green, and there doesn't seem to be any pest pressure on them.
Now I did find it super fascinating that for us, the two best ones were the really simple Lakhovsky coil with the opening pointing due north, and the other being a really simple, relatively short, surprisingly, bamboo stick with some, I think it's 8-gauge copper wire wrapped clockwise looking from the top down, which I guess from the soil up is anti-clockwise, but I don't know why that would make a great deal of difference. But the difference between the clockwise and the anti-clockwise was surprisingly marked. And fascinatingly, right in the middle somewhere is the control, and it was the only one really that had significant pest pressure that I could see. If you found this as fascinating as I have, check out my other experiments here and here, and I think I've got another one that I might be able to put here. I'll give it a go. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, I'm going to keep experimenting in my garden, so hit the subscribe button. And I think I found something I quite enjoy doing. Thanks for joining me. I'll catch you in the next one.